Iowa State University Extension and Outreach is helping Iowa farmers manage weeds, insects, and diseases in their fields. Pest management is key to high yields and quality grain.
Insects can impact yields in a couple ways, and one way is causing indirect injury, so they feed on the leaves, stems, roots, other plant parts, or they can directly feed on the seeds or the kernels. And so over time, with building numbers of pests, increasing damage to the direct and indirect injury, they can take away yield. We're never going to be able to control insects, and we're never going to be able to eliminate insects, but our best hope for farmers is to provide tools to suppress. We want to keep the numbers down as much as we can to protect the crop.
ISU Extension and Outreach specialists are providing the tools and resources farmers need to manage insect pests.
Being out in the field, it goes a long way. You can see the good insects, maybe the ones that we consider pests, and you can see them early before stand loss or plant death or anything really severe happens.
Disease can also have an economic impact on field crops by reducing yield and grain quality.
So my favorite question is when somebody asks me, what diseases can I expect for this coming growing season? I always like to say to that person, well, first of all, if you can tell me what the weather's going to be like, that's going to give me an indication of what diseases that I should maybe be on the lookout for. And then the other thing to remember is what hybrid or variety is being grown in that field. To get disease, you have to have a host, so that would be the crop that you're growing. You have to have the pathogen present, so that's the organism that's going to cause disease, has to be present in that field. And then the third part of that disease triangle is the environment. So we have to have environment that is conducive for disease.
To help farmers recognize problems, ISU Extension and Outreach offers scouting workshops and training to identify common diseases and insects that cause harm to Iowa crops. Specialists also provide information and education on evolving weeds of interest.
We've relied on herbicides almost entirely for the past 30 years, and that has worked well for the past 30 years. Whether we can continue that into the future is yet to be seen. Because the weeds are adapting so quickly to these fairly simple weed management systems. Palmer amaranth is a weed of new concern, and it's unique in that it is just moving into the state now. And so this is a weed farmers really need to keep an eye out for, just because it is more competitive than the weeds we are dealing with, and it's very good at evolving resistance to herbicides. Farmers really need to spend more time evaluating how they can diversify their weed management program. It's not as easy as switching herbicides, but I think it's going to be critical down the road.
In operation for over 50 years, Iowa State University's Plant and Insect Diagnostic Clinic helps Iowans diagnose and identify about 1,500 samples of weeds, insects, and diseases each year.
The purpose of the PIDC is to have a service where samples can come in, where everything is tracked, uniquely numbered, where we can report nationally the things that we're seeing, as well as providing that information then to Iowans and our clients about what's going on.
With a focus on weeds, insects, and diseases, Iowa State University Extension and Outreach is implementing integrated pest management strategies to help farmers grow healthy crops year after year.